Hi everyone, my name is Johan and I'm a senior cloud developer advocate working at Microsoft. In this video, we'll talk about packages, what they are, why they are important, and how to use them. But first, what's a package? A package is a reusable bundle of code that may also include other things like images, fonts, or any resources. Packages can be many things, like libraries that you use to build your applications. For example, React, Angular, or Express. They can also be tools like the TypeScript compiler, unit test runner, or code formatters. You'll probably use a lot of third-party packages to build your application. And at some point, you may even create your own private packages to share some components if you have multiple applications. Ultimately, even the application you're creating is a package. You may also hear sometimes the words dependencies or modules while going through documentation. It may be confusing at first, but it's only different words for meaning packages at the end. You might wonder now, where can I find packages to use in my project? In the JavaScript ecosystem, there's multiple places where you can find packages, but the most popular one is NPM. There's more than 1 million packages on NPM, and that number is growing every day. It's both a registry, meaning a place where you can share and download packages from, and also a CLI tool. The NPM CLI comes with every Node.js installation, and that's what we'll use to manage packages in our project. Now, why are packages important? If you look at this code here, this is a full functional web server built with less than 10 lines of JavaScript. Think about it for a second. If we did not use a package here, we would have to write way more code than that to handle the routing of the HTTP request, to create the HTTP response, to handle the formatting of the headers, the transformation of the data, and a lot of other complex and boring tasks. Thanks to the Express package and this single line of code we have here at the beginning, you don't have to code all of that. You can focus on what really matters and be way more productive. To be able to use packages in your application, it all starts with a file named package.json. This is a JSON file that consists of mainly three groups of information. You'll find in there a lot of metadata, like your project's name, version, license, and some other information. Then you'll find a dependencies section. This is the list of the packages that you use in your project. Said otherwise, this is the packages your project depends on. And finally, you have a script section. This is where you can put commands to automate your development tasks, like, for example, compiling your code or running your test. To create this file, you can use the npm CLI init command. It will ask you a bunch of questions and it will create the package.json file for you. If you want to start quickly, you can even skip the prompts and fill in the fields later using the -y option. Once you have the package.json file, you can start installing packages. For that, you have to use the command npm install, followed by the name of the package you want to install. If you add the option --dev to this command, the package will be added to a different section of your package.json file called dev dependencies instead of dependencies. But what's the difference between the two? In your project, you'll find two kinds of packages. There will be packages that your application needs in order to be able to run in production. These packages will be your dependencies. There are also packages that you need during the development of your app to help you, like test libraries, code formatters, or compiler tools. But these are only useful during development. You don't want to ship their code in production because it's useless. As these packages are only needed for development, that's why they are called dev dependencies. In the next video, Let's put all of that in practice and create a new project that uses packages.